in the 39 seats in Tamil Nadu, the one seat in Puducherry. There are three seats also in Chennai. Our alliance had won all the 40 seats last time in 2014. Anna DMK had won 37, BJP won, NR Congress won, PMK won. And this time we have formed the biggest and the best alliance that Tamil Nadu has ever seen. With the coming together of all these parties, we are confident that all the people of Tamil Nadu will support this alliance. There is the voice of all the people of Tamil Nadu in this alliance, and this alliance stands for a strong, stable, decisive, honest, and visionary leader, Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi. This alliance is working to strengthen Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi's government and to ensure that the next government will have a big voice of the people of Tamil Nadu, will have a big representation of the people of Tamil Nadu. And I am very confident that all the people of Tamil Nadu want Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi to once again become the Prime Minister and serve the people of India, serve the people of Tamil Nadu, and bring back the pride, the rich cultural heritage that Tamil Nadu has, that the people of Tamil Nadu are blessed with, that we have all offered to the rest of the world. When we released the manifesto, the Sankalp Patra, Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi had talked about the water problems of Tamil Nadu. Chennai itself faces a lot of water problems. The Bharatiya Janata Party and the National Democratic Alliance in Tamil Nadu is committed to set up an authority which will speedily implement the interlinking of rivers, which was started by Prime Minister Shri Atal Bihari Vajpayee. But for the 10 years, 2004 to 2014, when the Congress and DMK were in power, at that time, no work was done on the interlinking of rivers. After Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government came in, we started work once again on the interlinking of rivers. Honorable Minister Shri Nitin Gadkari has taken rapid measures to study the various links. 4 or 5 links have been prioritized, have been taken for initial implementation, of which the Godavari-Kaveri interlink has tremendous potential, and it will help all the southern states, including Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, and more particularly, the maximum benefit will come to the people of Tamil Nadu. We believe it's a long-term permanent solution to solve the water problems of Tamil Nadu, of the farmers of Tamil Nadu, the drinking water and household water problems of the people of Tamil Nadu. We have made a special mention in our manifesto to ensure that this project is taken up on mission mode. We will also be forming a special Ministry of Water for unifying all the water management functions and approaching the problems of water in a very comprehensive fashion. An all-round development of the issues of water for every part of India, particularly for Tamil Nadu. Having said that, we are also concerned that we must find some short-term measures to solve the problems of water, particularly for Chennai. And we have done significant research to see what can help us solve the problems of drinking water and household need. And along with the state government, led by Chief Minister E. Paniriswamy, Palaniswamy and the Deputy Chief Minister O. Paneerselvam, we are working to set up a series of desalination plants which will be powered by solar power and provide immediate relief to the people of Tamil Nadu, to the people of Chennai and all the other coastal areas in terms of drinking water, in terms of household requirement. We also believe that the Kusum Yojana that has been launched by the Narendra Modi government at the center will be a game changer for the farmers of Tamil Nadu. Under the Kusum Yojana, farmers will be encouraged to set up solar power generation in a part of their field. That solar power will be used to power the pumps of the farmer, and the balance power can be given to the grid of Tamil Nadu Power Corporation so that our farmers' income can increase significantly, both by the use of land for solar power and by increasing the crop that they are able to produce in their farms. We are also going to encourage energy efficient pumps and micro irrigation, drip irrigation, so that while on the one hand we are implementing the interlinking of rivers, on the other hand we'll do short-term solutions which will give immediate relief to the farmers and to the people of Tamil Nadu, particularly Chennai and other coastal areas. We have also decided, other than the new water ministry, to form a Department of Fisheries. This Department of Fisheries has already been implemented after the announcement on 1st February in the interim budget, and we have announced that fishery people engaged in fisheries and animal husbandry will also get Kisan credit card, will also get lower interest loan like farmers, and will also get a corpus of 10,000 crores which will be used to upgrade the infrastructure of our fishermen, to get them better mechanized trawlers, mechanized boats, set up better facilities at the port so that the income of our farmers also can go up. We are committed to the blue revolution so that all our fishermen can double their income by 2022. I would like to thank Honorable Shri Rajnikant ji for having welcomed the initiative of interlinking of rivers that has been announced by Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi and has been accepted. This was a long pending demand that Shri Rajnikant ji has been raising for the welfare of the farmers and the people of Tamil Nadu, and I welcome his comments by which he has thanked Prime Minister Modi for accepting his request for interlinking of rivers. We are also committed to giving all the farmers, big or small. Earlier, the Pradhan Mantri Kisan Sanman Nidhi PM Kisan Yojana was to provide 6,000 rupees to the small and marginal farmers. In our Sankalp Patra manifesto, we have decided that all farmers, irrespective of land holding, will now be given 6,000 rupees every year as an income support. This was a demand that was raised by many farmer organizations. Some farmer organizations met our senior leaders also, Mr. Ayakanna had also met our party president and made this demand. I am happy to announce that all farmers in the country will now be eligible to get 6,000 rupees every year as income support. Another issue that Mr. Ayakanna had raised was about pension for farmers. I am happy to say that our manifesto has announced that we will come out with a scheme for pension for farmers also. Mr. Ayakanna has welcomed all these initiatives, the interlinking of rivers, 6,000 rupees for all farmers, pension scheme for farmers, and has also welcomed the fact that our government has announced a minimum support price for 22 products, which will be 1.5 times of the cost of production, and has extended support to the alliance in Tamil Nadu and to Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi and the NDA all over India by farmer organizations because of the concrete and very strong measures being taken to double the farmers' income by 2022. In addition to that, Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi is very committed to protecting the heritage and the rich culture of Tamil Nadu. You will all recall that when Prime Minister Modi was in Chennai last month, he had announced that Chennai Central Station will be named after MGR. He had also announced that announcements in the trains coming and in the planes coming to aeroplanes coming to the airports in Tamil Nadu, the announcements will also be made in the Tamil language. We have already started printing the tickets, railway tickets, from last 1 year. Exactly 1 year ago, on 14th April 2018, we had started printing of UTS tickets in the railways in Tamil language also. Earlier, it was only in Hindi and English. Modi ji's government has started the printing of tickets in Tamil Nadu also. We believe that India needs a strong government and a strong leader to protect it from terrorism and to keep the unity and integrity of India safe. You all know what had happened in Coimbatore a few years ago. You will recall that in my city of Mumbai, where I come from, there was a terror attack on 26th November 2008, in which more than 100 people lost their lives and several hundred were injured. For 3 days, the terrorists attacked Mumbai. But even after that, the Congress DMK government in the center did not take any action against terrorists. It is only Prime Minister Modi's government which first did the surgical strike. And when the terrorists attacked our Jawans, we responded with full force and we even crossed the line of control and attacked the terror camps at Balakot to give a fitting response to terrorism. I think the country needs a leader like Prime Minister Narendra Modi who will ensure that terrorism can never get a place in India, and a befitting reply is given if any terrorist tries to look at India with an evil eye. Also, I must share with all of you the comments of the leaders of the Congress, which have already started threatening the middle class with higher taxes. Mr. Sam Pitroda, who is the guru, who is the ideologue of the Congress leader Rahul Gandhiji, has already indicated that the middle class should pay more taxes. But Prime Minister Narendra Modi is committed to reducing taxes, unlike the Congress, which wants to increase taxes. As you are aware, we have removed all taxes. No income tax for those who earn taxable income up to 5 lakh rupees in the interim budget on 1st February. So Modi ji is continuously trying to reduce taxes. Congress has already started talking of increasing taxes on the middle class. Similarly, we have decided to form a national commission for the welfare of traders. We have already decided that all traders and all small businessmen will be given 10 lakh rupees free accident insurance. We have also taken strong steps against black money, against corruption, which I think is not acceptable to the DMK and Congress, which is totally a coalition of corrupt parties. Their candidates are in jail, their candidates are on bail, their candidates are fighting jail, they are again and again taking anticipatory bail. The people of India want an honest, clean government, and that can only be provided by Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi, not by a party whose senior most leader, whose president himself, is out on bail on serious charges of irregularity and fraudulent monetary transactions. Today, the leader of the Congress party is himself facing very serious charges. The leaders of the Congress party, whose son is fighting in Shivaganga, is himself facing very serious charges. The 2G case is under appeal, in which the senior leaders of the DMK are facing serious charges. The case of another senior leader of the DMK, who is alleged to have used irregularly phone connections which are available to a minister from BSNL for his personal benefit and his own company's benefit. These are all serious allegations of corruption, and I'm sure the people of Tamil Nadu will never tolerate this type of corruption and will ensure that they elect an alliance which will support Prime Minister Modi in his effort to give clean government and honest government to India. I would also like to share with you how Rahul Gandhiji insulted the engineers of the integral coach factory in Chennai, who have developed, designed and developed and manufactured the Train 18, which is the first Indian developed train set and which is serving the people of India very well. Now we are planning to make more than 100 train sets, which will provide jobs to lakhs of people, which will provide income opportunity to lakhs of people. But Rahul Gandhiji does not want development of India. He wants India to continue to import trains and train sets. I don't know whether he wants it to come from Italy, rather than being made by our engineers in Chennai, in the integral coach factory in Chennai. I would like to also mention here that we have decided to invest 25 lakh crore rupees for upgrading the infrastructure in agriculture and rural India, and 100 lakh crore rupees in the overall development of infrastructure in India. This will be invested in roads, national highways, railways, airports, seaways, inland waterways. All of these investments will provide crores and crores of youth income opportunities and working opportunities, because the people of India want to be self-sufficient, want to be self-reliant, want to be living a life of dignity, and to go and make India a developed nation. The Bharatiya Janata Party and the NDA stand for a developed India and do not want our youth to miss out on the opportunities that the world is presenting today. So I wish the voters of Tamil Nadu my best wishes. I am sure that on 18th April, all the voters on Tamil Nadu will elect a government at the center led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, will elect a government just like they had supported Puruchi Thalaivi Amma Jayalalita ji in the last election. They will continue to support the alliance of AIADMK, PMK, DMDK.